Hi everyone, Joe here, and today I want to talk about color grading and more specifically about how to achieve the famous orange and teal look we've seen by now in every single feature film. I'm going to briefly discuss the main idea behind it, and then we'll get right into Premiere to make it happen. Of course, if you don't have access to Premiere, you can do it just the same in a free program like DaVinci Resolve, for example. So without any further ado, let's get started. So the main idea behind this look is that orange and teal are complementary colors, which means that if we take a color wheel, you can find them at opposite ends. And complementary colors tend to work nicely together and are the simplest color harmony you can find in color theory. Of course, you could use other couples of complementary colors, let's say green and magenta, but those don't work as well with skin tones, so that's why this look is the most popular. So to give you a reference, this is the final result we are going for, and we have our orange skin tones and our bluish shadows, and I've added a bit of contrast to make the image a bit more dramatic. Ideally, you want to have a shot when your background is either neutral or of a really different color than your skin tones, which is going to make the masking part much easier, but with a bit of elbow grease we can make do anyway. So I'm going to delete all of the effects and we're going to build this again from scratch. There are of course several ways you can do this, but the best one I've found in Premiere is the three-way color corrector. So we want to head over to the effects panel and add it to our clip. And to make our mask, we want to open the secondary color correction tab and click on the little eyedropper to select our main skin tone. And if we select the show mask option, we can see we already have a pretty decent selection. But to make it actually usable, we want to add the rest using this eyedropper with a plus next to it, to select everything else we're missing. Of course, you can be more or less precise, depending on how much time you've got, but something like this will do for our purposes. Now we can actually grade the image by pulling our color wheels towards the orange side, and you can make it more or less dramatic depending on what you're going for. We can then of course fine-tune our saturation, our contrast and whatnot, but you get the idea. Making the rest of the image teal at this point is even easier. We just need to copy and paste the effect we've just created, then go to the secondary color correction tab and invert the mask we've just created. Now we can turn those color wheels towards the opposite side. Again, we can fine-tune our mask or make other adjustments to our image, but as for the orange and teal look part, we are done. In this case, I'd also suggest reducing saturation just a bit as for the teal part, but of course it depends on your shot and on the exact look you're going for. Finally, we can then also add some other corrections, for example add a bit of contrast, but I'd recommend making these below the effects we've just created, not to mess up too much with the masks. So that was it for this tutorial. If there's something specific you'd like to see in the next one, feel free to leave that in the comment section down below. And as always, thank you so much for watching. This was Joe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. And more specifically about how to achieve the famous color grading, and more specifically about how to achieve the famous color